This morning, we are unveiling a special series, and we're calling it Meet the Moment. From authors to activists, community leaders, poets, and scientists, the voices outside of our politics shaping conversations that matter. We begin with actor Selma Blair, who's known for her deadpan humor with quirky, intelligent performances in iconic films like Cruel Intentions, Heathers, and Legally Blonde.
What are the boys like?
Ow!
Cecile, is that all you can think of?
Doesn't look like anyone's coming to your little party to me, Heather.
Vivian Kensington, do you think it's acceptable that Ms. Woods is not prepared?
No. I don't.
5 years ago, at age 46, Blair was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis after battling the autoimmune disease from the age of 7. In 2019, she walked onto the red carpet with a cane for the first time at an Oscars after party, making her disability visible in a powerful way. Now, Blair has become an advocate for Americans living with disabilities, joining President Biden at the White House in October to recognize the 33rd anniversary of the Americans with Disabilities Act and to advocate for new legislation for disability rights and pay equity.
I'm here before you today as a proud disabled woman with my cane and my service dog Scout by my side. Our laws and policies must reflect that our disabled lives are not of lesser value.
Selma Blair, welcome to Meet the Press. Thank you for being here. You were diagnosed 5 years ago with multiple sclerosis. You're in remission now. How are you doing, Selma?
I am in remission, so that is a very safe place to be, you know, as far as diagnoses go. But I do have, even though there's no evidence of current disease activity, I do still have the leftovers because it does. I did have it for many years and didn't know, and it does leave some, you know, burn areas, some scar tissue and all that. And mine is in the basal ganglia movement and stuff. So some of my stuff looks a little different than other people with MS. There's a gazillion types of MS, wherever your damage is. But I'm doing really well.
You have your beautiful dog Scout here with you. Are you in any pain? Talk about the strength you find every day.
I am. I'm in pain every day. Every day. And sometimes I have to. I have dystonia also that really doesn't always flare up for entire conversations, but it's almost like someone with a stutter maybe or a type of Tourette's. So things go in and out and people don't always understand that. So there can be a lot of discrimination and confusion, I think, with people thinking I'm putting something on and then I have a dog and I just want a dog with me. So there's a lot of tricky stuff. But the real fact is I really am in pain all the time. There's a stiffness that does not leave me.
I want to talk to you about your journey to diagnosis. You have written about it. You have done a documentary about it. You say that you had symptoms starting at 7 years old.
I mean, there is a prodromal period, so I'm not certain that it actually was like a full-on, but there is, my neurologist was explaining, there can be years of prodromal, you know, accruing and great fatigue and problems. But I did. I had the thing where you bend down, I get electricity. I had very clear signs at that time. I had optical neuritis as a child, which really is only from brain trauma or MS. And yet they didn't recognize it in me, even though I was seeking doctors my entire childhood.
Thanks for watching. Stay updated about breaking news and top stories on the NBC News app or follow us on social media.